obviously neither one of these valves are going to do anything. They don't have neutral. So that's kind of odd. How will they run then? They're not going to run when the drain pump is running. And let's just suppose, just for grins, this wouldn't actually happen in operation, but let's suppose that the cold water triac closes. So it lets line come in. How about now? Yeah, we got a triac attack. Suppose that both of these triacs now close as shown. Will the cold water valve run? Will it open up, let cold water in with the drain pump running? No. No, and it's got line on both sides of it. If this were to actually happen, just suppose. In fact, what we've got, simplified diagram of that, we've got, if both of these were to close, as I've drawn them in the tech sheet, back in the schematic, no, it wouldn't trip the breaker either, Jeremy. Because all that's happening is if this triac were to close while the drain pump triac is closed, this is a drain pump triac, this is a triac for the water valve. They're both, one side of these, each triac is connected to line. Remember, as we saw over here. So each side of the, each one of these triacs, on one side of them, they're getting line. So what I've done is I've taken this and I've drawn a simplified sketch, just so we can see more easily what's going on. So if the drain pump triac is closed and the water valve, WV water valve, actually it's, and it wouldn't matter, it's the same, cold water, hot water, didn't matter. If both of these were to close, then what's happening here is that the water valve is being shunted. So it's not going to run. Remember, you can't push electrons. Electrons aren't going to move unless there is a difference in voltage between two points, right? So if you've got 120 volts here and 120 volts on this side, there's no difference in voltage, and it's the same phase, you know, L1 on both sides. If you had L1 and L2, yeah, it would run. You'd have 240 volts across that valve and probably burn it out. It's probably not rated for 240. But anyway, that's a side point. The point here is that there is no difference in voltage in order to push electrons. Electrons don't have a mind of their own. They can't move on their own. They're happy to stay with whatever atom they're attached to in the copper wire until there is a difference in voltage pressure that forces them to move down the wire, to leave that atom and keep on moving. So what would have to happen in order to make the water valve run? Right, so you'd have to close off the drain pump triac, and then we'll look at it first in a simplified diagram, and then we'll go and look at it on the actual little more complicated one. So now with the drain pump triac closed, now we would then be getting neutral to the water valve. But look, it's going through the drain pump. Loads in series. Common configuration in the old school appliances. You'd see this a lot in dryers, dropping resistors, for the timer motor, for example. Common situation. How does this work? I mean, how is it possible that the water valve is getting enough operating voltage to do its job? This works, assuming we've got 120 volt water valve, which they don't give us the spec in the tech sheet, but remember that in a series circuit, the voltage drop across any load will be proportional to the resistance of that load. So this would work if the resistance of the water valve was much, much greater than the resistance of the drain pump. So that being the case, then, the voltage drop of the water valve will be much, much greater than the voltage drop of the drain pump. Because remember, E is equal to I times R. And in a series circuit like what we have here, the current is the same at every point in the circuit. It's the same here, same here, same here, same here, same here, same here. It's the same current throughout the circuit. It doesn't compress. The electrons don't compress as they're moving through the wire. So if the resistance of the water valve coil is much, much greater than the resistance of the drain pump motor winding, it becomes the controlling resistance for that circuit, because the total resistance is equal to R of the water valve plus R of the drain pump. Water valve. And so if this resistance is much, much greater than this one, like what I've said here, it's going to be dropping the lion's share of the voltage. The drain pump will effectively be acting like a wire because its resistance is so much smaller than that of the water valve.